Meta has sued several companies for questionable web scraping practices, but it's still possible to scrape Facebook without getting banned. Let me tell you how. First, respect the platform rules. Even if it sounds obvious, it's the main reason for the lawsuit I already mentioned. So, before you start scraping Facebook, it is crucial to know what's allowed. For starters, check the robot's TXT file to check any restrictions for automation. It'll show you which parts of the website can be accessed by crawlers. Also, take some time to familiarize yourself with Facebook's terms of service and platform policies. For instance, the statement says you shouldn't scrape data without permission or unauthorized. Following the rules also includes scraping only public data that are freely available. It means scraping pages, groups, or information that's accessible without logging in. If you plan to scrape user details, get their written consent and comply with GDPR. Now, tip number two. Use only reliable and authorized scraping tools. Facebook allows developers to use their Graph API for some data extraction. Of course, there are plenty of unofficial APIs online, but before committing to one, review their documentation and read user reviews to get the whole picture. Besides APIs, you can also opt for well-documented scraping libraries and frameworks like Selenium and Playwright. Of course, it's only an option if you have sharp coding skills. Otherwise, building a scraper might be too tricky. But no matter, if you make your own or buy ready-made scrapers, reliable tools will make your Facebook scraping journey smoother and more effective. Talking about necessary tools, use Facebook proxies. By distributing your scraping requests across different IP addresses, you can prevent blocks, access your targeted geolocation, and ensure uninterrupted scraping. To avoid any roadblocks and restrictions, consider using rotating residential IPs. Trust us, it's a game changer. Every year, we conduct proxy market research to find the best proxies for every target. You can watch this video for proxy provider recommendations or check the links in the video description. Now back to the video. Next step, mimic human behavior to increase your scraping success rate. When scraping Facebook, add random delays between your requests and vary the timing. This helps you fly under the radar and avoids detection. If your scraper has a cookie collector, use this handy feature and build up your browser profile before digging into tasks. Oh, and remember to respect rate limits. Excessive requests can lead to IP blocks or account suspension. The next step is to pay attention to the scraper's technical specifications. For successful scraping, we recommend implementing or looking for tools with automatic retry techniques. It'll help you deal with network failures, timeouts, and API rate limit errors. You should also cache your data to avoid unnecessary requests. And finally, make sure your tool handles dynamic content. It's the type of content that changes based on user behavior, location, and interests. And if you conquer it, you can get valuable insights about your targeted user base. We hope these tips will help you start extracting Facebook data. And if you need some extra support, check out our Facebook scraping tutorial. The link is in the description. I'll see you in the next video.